first and foremost, we saw some extraordinary courage in that courtroom today. The victim of Mr. Hastert stood up and was heard after decades of unfathomable silence. He stood up and spoke the truth of what Mr. Hastert did to him as a boy, how Coach abused him, violated his trust, and in doing so, permanently scarred him. That was courageous. That was selfless. That was important. And I am in awe. We also had Jolene Burns, the sister of another victim, who today was able to bring her brother's case into this courtroom. She stood up in a court of law in the defendant's presence on behalf of her deceased brother and spoke the truth of what Mr. Hastert had done to him as a boy and the tragic consequences of that abuse. That was courageous. That was important. That was selfless, and I am in awe of it. But for the tenacity of our federal law enforcement team here in Chicago, including the FBI, the IRS, and this U.S. Attorney's Office, this day of reckoning would not have come. This curtain would not have been pulled back on these dark secrets. Mr. Hastert's legend and legacy as a public servant would have gone untarnished. History would have told a lie. But because of law enforcement's efforts and tenacity, the curtain has been pulled back. We followed the case where it led. We brought the charges we could bring. And through that, Mr. Hastert's legend and legacy are gone. And in its place are a broken, humiliated man. That is as it should be. Is anybody satisfied with this process and this sentencing, given the gravity of the historic crime? Of course not. Of course not. I wish Mr. Hastert had been called on the carpet in 1968, and we'd all be better for it. This is imperfect. But it's what we got. And I do think that the fact that we were able to have this day of reckoning is in small part a tribute to law enforcement, but I can't say loud enough how grateful and respectful I am to Jolene Burge and to that other individual that stepped up today in open court and with honesty and integrity and dignity and pain told their story. And what I hope is that that will embolden other victims to come forward, to recognize that their voice can be heard, should be heard, needs to be heard, no matter how powerful your abuser. There are those among us who are ready, willing, and able to hear you and to believe you and to move forward.